me little sugar buggers, welcome back to the channel for a brand new mod review. Yesterday, we talked all about Kiara Sims' aspirations. Today, we're going to talk about her traits. The two definitely go hand in hand, and I feel like if you're going to introduce aspirations, you should absolutely have traits that kind of supplement those goals, those hobbies, those dreams. Now, as I've already mentioned, I genuinely believe the start of a good save, a good gameplay experience is investing in your sim. Think carefully, think long and hard about the person that they're going to be, and with these custom traits and aspirations, I feel like tailor-making your sim to have a very specific personality is easier than ever. Not to mention, I do believe there is a way in MCC Command Center, or maybe it's a different mod, I'm not 100% sure, that you can add in multiple traits. So you're not necessarily married to the three that you have here. You can always add on, especially if your sim is a little more complex than others. So again, I definitely think that you guys should check out the aspiration mods. I posted it yesterday. Check it out, give it a look, and then come back to me because we're going to be kind of referencing that a little bit. So with the traits, y'all, she has like 74 in total, and they're broken down into 5 different categories. So she has lifestyle traits, which would be over here. She has child and toddler traits. She also has emotional. We've got, of course, social. And then last but not least, we have hobby. The cool thing about this bundle is I feel like a lot of these traits can also back up existing aspirations in The Sims and also personality as well. I feel like there are so many traits that are still missing to this day. For instance, I genuinely thought this flirty trait came from the game until I had to look it up. Lo and behold, it is part of the trait bundle. These Sims tend to be romantic and love to flirt with other Sims. I also love the fact that she's add in love paparazzi and also hates paparazzi. So you could have maybe a celebrity that just, you know, was thrown into the limelight, but maybe absolutely freaking hates it. And then I do believe we've got a couple other here, a couple other ones that kind of pertain to like love and faithfulness. For instance, we literally have a trait now that says unfaithful. These Sims like to play the field and often cheat on their partners. We have a woohoo lover. These Sims love to woohoo with other Sims. And then if we scroll all the way up, I do believe there is one that is called like baby daddy, and it's literally a hobby. Like it cracks me up. I kind of want like the baby mama hobby or trait rather, or I guess it's like a hobby trait for women, because I mean, you know, your girl could be like a gold digger or something. Psh, maybe, I have no idea. I mean, do we not remember Stella McCarthy? Like, hello, was it McCarthy? I don't forget, remember, it was a long time ago. These Sims want to have as many kids as possible with different women. I also believe baby mama, the baby mama trait, would be beautiful in a 100 baby scenario. But anyway, there's boxer, we've got bar drinker, beauty lover, candy lover, coffee lover, all different types of lovers. Your Sims can actually have hobbies that they really enjoy. There's grandparent here. We've got green thumb. So maybe if you wanted to use one of the custom aspirations and you really wanted your Sim to become, I think it's actually under creativity, maybe a master floral ranger, you could go ahead and apply like the green thumb aspiration. You could also throw in one of like the base game aspirations, creative. And then I feel like you could really like tailor make this to be exactly how you want it, with these, you know, with these custom traits. Also, not to mention with the unfaithful trait, there is a faithful option as well, which I thought was really cool. And I don't know if you guys saw the house husband, a married man whose main occupation is caring for his family, managing his household affairs and doing housework. They learn baking, cooking, and parenting skills much faster than most Sims. So that leads me to my next point here. These traits just aren't like little game tags. They will actually have perks associated with them. So for instance, you had a Sim who was an all-rounder. I actually do believe there is a athletic aspiration called all-rounder. And basically all-rounders have a passion for yoga, swimming, and being at the gym. And then you could also apply this secondary trait. These Sims love swimming, yoga, and going to the gym. they also learn the fitness and wellness skills faster than other Sims. Having a skill advantage to other Sims isn't the only thing that you will actually acquire with these custom traits. Your Sims will get buffs, they will also get social interactions and even whims, which I think is really incredible. They feel super immersive and very official. I did want to mention that all of the traits that you guys have seen today, if you've just been kind of browsing on the screen, are actually a part of this bundle. I don't have any custom traits from anybody else. The only one that might be there is from the LGBTQIA mod. I really love to keep all of these trait bundles from one creator. It's super easy to update and I love how they play with each other. But I wanted to also just talk or kind of highlight a couple other ones that I thought were really, really cool. I love the geology lover. These Sims have an interest in exploring the world and its history. And knowing that they're gonna get whims and stuff that are like, you know, like that actually apply to this trait is really freaking cool to me. And then if we scroll down a little bit further, I do believe it's actually maybe in lifestyle, but oh, this is another thing. You can kind of set your preference whether your Sim loves to ski or snowboard more. Your Sim also can be a space lover and a stargazer, which I thought was really exciting. But I loved the fact that your Sim can be spiritual. I thought that was super neat. But I did want to show you a nice little combination of a base game aspiration with some of these custom traits. So for instance, love, serial romantic. I feel like you can really beef it up now. You can make your Sim flirty, which I think is, you know, a good way to kind of like entice some Sims. And then if you, you know, your Sim wanted to, you know, be a little bit of a thotty, yaddy, yaddy, you could make him a baby daddy, yaddy, yaddy. Or you can scroll down a little bit more and apply the seducer trait. Ooh. Remember, you can add in more if you have MCC Command Center, or maybe it's Slice of Life. I'm not sure. It's one of the two. But then, okay, the one that I was actually really getting at here would probably be the unfaithful. I would assume the unfaithful trait, and then maybe even throwing in like woohoo lover. See, like that's a really nice combo. And the thing is you can have like a few different Sims from the same aspiration. They're not all gonna have the same damn traits, which I thought was kind of cool. Like there's some other ones that you guys saw that you can kind of play around with. But for Brianna here and our little gameplay segment, I kind of wanted to see what the all-rounder trait and aspiration looked like. So for instance, we're going to give her a aspiration. We're also going to give her the all-rounder trait. I wanted to check out some of the interactions and whims that are associated with that. But then I wanted to also go and give her the spiritual, I guess, the spiritual aspiration or trait here. I keep thinking they're aspirations for some reason, which is really silly. And then I do believe there should be another one here, maybe possibly in hobby. Oh, and you can make your Sims like really girly or also like a tomboy. I know in real life a lot of people don't like those labels, but when it comes to gameplay, I feel like having labels is kind of like, it makes sense. But of course, if you don't want to play that way, you don't have to. Like, nobody's telling you you have to. Okay, so where am I? What am I looking for? I kind of wanted, I think there was like yoga lover or something like that. I can't remember. Okay, there we go. So we have yoga lover. We have that she's spiritual. She also is an all-rounder Sim with the ultimate aspiration of being an all-rounder. I wanted to go ahead and showcase the all-rounder aspiration as well as Brianna's traits with you guys. So I decided to have her come over to the Movers and Shakers Fitness Center for a little wellness evaluation. Now, according to Kiara Sims, your Sim will have an accelerated wellness skill rate. So even though Brianna here, I keep wanting to call her Kiara for some reason, like I feel like it just fits the Sim. Even though she's never, ever, ever done any type of yoga or anything in her life, she already blasted through the first skill. Look how fast this freaking goes. I mean, she still looks like Bambi out here because she's never done this before, but I think it's really cute that she's giving it a fair try. So I noticed with her aspiration, again, these are two different mods, she already checked off having the first yoga class, doing a private yoga session at home, and reaching a level 5 of the wellness goal. So she's already made some solid progress towards completing the do some yoga portion of her aspiration, which I guess is like level 2. Now, I did notice over here, she wants to buy a yoga mat, and this whim comes from the all-rounder aspiration, while leveling up in the painting skill actually comes from her spiritual trait, which I think is so freaking cute. So apparently there are a couple brand new interactions that we can perform that actually pertain to our aspiration. So I'm going to have Brianna come back down, and she's going to chat with the yoga instructor just a little bit, so maybe we can do some of these interactions. Hopefully it'll work. Like I said, this is the first time I've ever, like, you know, obviously looked at this mod. Actually, it's not the first time. I have this in my legacy right now. What am I even saying? Well, I guess I mean the first time that I've checked out this part of it. There is the first impression sentiments in action. I love that so much. I'm wondering where the... Oh, there we go. I love that there's, like, a yoga mat. So we can go and ask for some flexibility tips because, like I said, this was Brianna's first yoga class, and Ish was getting a little rough. Now, I'm trying to ask her, but I don't think she ended up actually telling me. Or maybe she did. I'm not sure. But just know that the ability to do that is absolutely freaking there. And then now she's stretching. Oh, so cute. All right. So is there anybody else that we can kind of talk to a little bit and maybe be able to, you know, take a little look at those interactions? I love that. This just makes my Sims feel more immersive. Like, I actually feel like she is a fitness buff. I genuinely do. And just having these, like, you know, few little interactions kind of just drives it home for me. All right, so let me go and try this one more time. I don't know if it's going to be able to... Oh, wait, hold on. I see it here. We can express the love for swimming. We can also give spiritual advice because obviously we're spiritual. We can give yoga advice. Like, we have any. We can explain spiritual lifestyle. We can talk about spiritual beliefs. And then I do believe you guys probably... Oh, yoga poses. Okay. And then I think you guys saw... I'm not 100% sure if you ended up seeing it, but we can discuss cognitive focusing methods. I love this so much. And it feels really official to me. I love that depending on what traits you have, you know, for your Sims, you'll unlock different interactions. She actually has the shy trait, which is interesting. Maybe that was like something that I applied to her in the beginning because there is a shy trait that comes with this mod. So I'll read off the moodlet anyway. It says, I'm so happy to be home where I feel comfortable around myself and only Sims I know can come inside. But yeah, that is really cute. So since she does want to buy a yoga mat, I was kind of started thinking maybe we should have her go home and purchase one because obviously we don't have a yoga mat, and our first class was a success. We like it so much that we would totally do a few home sessions. We don't really have a lot of money to spend, so hopefully Brianna can afford a yoga mat. I don't know which one she would go with, but I kind of feel like the bamboo tree yoga mat is definitely right up her alley. We're gonna place it in the back here so that she can get a gorgeous view of this big old rock back here. And also because she did have a whim to do a little painting, I want to see if we can afford to get an easel. I don't think we can because we're a few hundred simoleons shy. I'm gonna have her go and maybe put it on her front porch here just to not clutter up the back. And then since she does have the whim, oh wait, it just went away. Perfect. Is she gonna get another whim? I don't know how many there are, but I was trying to like cycle through. Okay, hold on. Level up in the wellness skill. I love this so much. Like I was trying to mention to you guys in the aspirations video, these two really go hand in hand. So it almost feels like I'm kind of reviewing the, you know, it's like a twofer, you know, like the two for one type of video. But I honestly feel like between the aspirations, the new sentiments, you know, various other mods I've been reviewing lately, even these traits, I feel like if you are stuck or you're in a position where you just don't know where to go with the game, but like you're kind of just over the generic aspirations that you have with your packs, I definitely think you guys should give this a try because it just creates a whole new lifestyle almost for your Sims and a new direction for the player. Honestly, it kind of gets you out of your shell a little bit because I'm gonna be real with you. I never, like, I have Sims that are focused on, you know, wellness and athleticism and things like that, but they often follow like the same path. Like, I don't get them to go out and do as much as I'd like them to. And I feel like these whims kind of push me to do that. Does that make sense? I don't know. But I'm really excited to see like how this changes your gameplay really, truly deeply. She is currently in the zone and she's feeling elated. So yes, there are some moodlets that come with these traits. Yoga resonates deeply within the body and soul. It offers self-reflection, kindness, and continued growth. Yoga lover, the body can move in so many ways, and yoga brings it all to light. Yoga is perfect for the mind, body, and soul. Seriously, you guys have no idea how excited this makes me when it comes to my own personal gameplay and LPs in general. Little key detail here, the reason why the Foreman's is taking so long is because I am completely revamping that save to fit my current gameplay style and the way that I create my Sims now. Every time I used to jump into that save after I freaking finally like fixed it, I realized how like weird it felt to play in there, because it was like a style, it was a time that I feel like I've kind of moved on from. Not them specifically, I love that family, I love what they bring to the table, but I feel like it was like a time capsule with mods, you know? So I kind of want to update it, bring it to speed, and I didn't realize how long that was gonna take because it's a huge freaking save. So I'm really excited to implement all of these tools into that gameplay and see where it takes us. You know what I mean? Like, I feel like it's gonna be epic and it's gonna be a really cool freaking story and an even better journey. And I can't wait to like be able to really bring the Foreman's to life. So just wanted to go ahead and like throw that in there. All right, so I did have her go and paint in the painting skill, right? She just like entered it. She didn't level up yet because she just began in it, but I thought maybe possibly like that would kind of sort of count. I finally got Rihanna to level up, and then we ended up getting a few whims in the wanting to paint whims place, if that makes sense. So she would like to go for a jog from her all-rounder aspiration, and then she would also like to do a yoga routine. I know that that was only a tiny glimpse into a relatively huge mod, but I'm gonna leave the rest for you guys to discover. I just wanted to go ahead and show you all a few highlights and give you an example of how you can deepen your gameplay and make your Sims, well, a lot less boring in my personal opinion. So if you're interested in checking out the traits bundle or the aspiration bundle, I will go ahead and provide links in the description. Also, I will provide a link to, at the end of the video, to a more thorough, in-depth mod review on the aspirations themselves. So with that said, you guys, I'm gonna go ahead and wrap up this video here. I hope that you all enjoyed. And if you did, you know what to do, boo. Don't forget to go ahead and comment, rate, and subscribe. Let me know what you guys think in the comments down below, where the sun does not shine. And I will see you all next time. Bye, guys.